Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention for a moment. You are very welcome here today to our 2021 conferring ceremony. Before the ceremony commences, and for the safety and comfort of our guests, I would like to bring the following information to your attention. There are four exits in this room, one exit to the left, one exit to the right, and two exits to the rear of the room. In the unlikely event of an emergency, we would ask you to proceed directly and calmly to the exit nearest to you. When exiting the building, please do not use the lift. Once outside the building, you are asked to proceed to the assembly point in the car park to the left or to the right of the building. We are strictly adhering to COVID safety guidelines. We ask that you wear your face mask throughout the ceremony and to please remain in your allocated seats. In preparation for the ceremony, I would ask guests to please turn off their mobile phones. Please be aware that this event will be live streamed online and photographed. If you can please stand for the graduand procession. Thank you.
Please be seated. Ian Erica, a green Ushla file to arrive, could Ian Sharman the shop in a run. Aulamori and Kalashta. Distinguished guests, graduands, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this graduation ceremony at which third level awards will be conferred on learners of Griffith College. Our panel members include Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, Deputy Mayor of Limerick, Tom Ruddle, Kevin O'Sullivan, Head of Griffith College, Limerick, Ronan Fenlon, Director of Griffith College, Judy Burke and Eilish McCarthy, Program Directors, and the faculty lecturers involved in the delivery of the college's programs. I'm Dr. Thomas McGuckagon, the college's Director of Academic Programs, and I have the pleasure of being your MC for this graduation ceremony. Kantusa Karlesh de Himakti, Iramanish, Erntolov de Amitegrity, Ukhtaron Kalash de Griefa, Lauertsling, Herkiana Kalash de. I would like to begin the proceedings by inviting Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to deliver a conferring address.
Distinguished guests, colleagues, graduands, ladies and gentlemen. Number one, can you hear me? I'm greatly relieved I didn't receive the same answer I received the last time I asked that question in a lecture room, which was from somebody at the back of the hall said, I can hear you, but I'd happily swap with someone who can't. I'm sorry, as I look out and I see everybody, in fact, I see a sea of masks in front of me. Obviously, we must be very, very careful now in the light of the recent trend, recent increases in numbers, but I see all the masks in front of me. The thought occurs to me, the errant thought comes to me, saying, all we need for you now is, in fact, for each of you is a pair of sunglasses and a hoodie, and we'd have a perfect gang of bank rowers. So, on a more serious note, just to say, this is your day, and on the day like this, I think it really occurs to us the realization of life's dreams and ambitions. It's like a journey through mountainous terrain. Each struggle to a new peak is rewarded with a clear vision of the way ahead. And today, we celebrate your conquering that first peak. Today is your day at the mountaintop. So savor this moment and the vista it gives you, and let us joy live in your memory for life. Remember, however, that journeys, difficult journeys, are achieved through the guidance and experience and dedication of others. Your guides were families, partners, and friends who shared your trials and tribulations, prepared meals for you, put up with your inevitable but hopefully few cranky moods, and those who so readily accepted the stress you were so relieved to pass on. Now, in the time-honored tradition of Griffith College, I'm going to ask the parents, partners, families, and friends to stay seated while the graduates stand up. Now, I want you, the graduates, to turn to your parents, partners, families, and friends beside you, on either side, and express thanks for the support that you have received over the years by acclamation, applause, or however way you like. Well done, thank you. Do sit down. Now, if anybody asks me how the graduation speech went, I would say, well, it was interrupted by applause. as far as acknowledging support, I'm sure you would also wish me, as president of the college, to acknowledge the support of received by the work of my colleagues as members of boards, as heads of faculties, as lecturers, administrators and librarians, whose work contributed to your success today. I'm delighted to welcome our distinguished guest, Tom Ruddle, Deputy Mayor of Limerick. I'm particularly delighted to welcome Tom as an alumnus of Griffith College, who we have had the good fortune to have Tom do a mediation course with us. I'm sure, in fact, Tom had this well before he did the mediation course, but he has a problem-solving approach, okay? He's been heavily involved as a volunteer in a number of local organisations. He's acted as chair of the Newcastle Rovers and co-chair of the Newcastle West Football Club. His professional qualifications are in insurance, financial advice, mediation, mortgage broking and auctioneering. And he's a founding member of Newcastle West Lions Club. So thank you for being with us today, Tom. Today I want to look at the COVID landscape through which you have travelled, how it has challenged you and how it has changed us all forever. You faced many trials, including some here, for some here, the grief of loss of someone dearly loved. We ourselves lost our chairman, Frank Scotland, to COVID last month. Not just a close friend for over 40 years, Frank was a mentor and inspiration to us all. We were inspired by his courage and his tenacity in fighting illness for so many years. In his case, it was cancer. And his piercing objectivity applied to the resolution of many conflicting situations here in the college. We describe our loss in these words: the unrelenting minute he filled with service done, our maker's meaning in it, for so his life was run. Farewell, you Christian soldier, your courage ne'er undone. Rest well, you Christian soldier, for you life's battle won. Many in this audience who have lost close relatives or friends to COVID will understand the depth of grief occasioned by it, and our thoughts and our condolences are with them. We're currently living a worldwide track that has changed our lives beyond recognition. We never anticipated that a 21-day global lockdown would actually go on for months and turn our lives upside down. We started doing things differently. We needed to be creative and work with what we had, and started witnessing some historic changes worldwide. While COVID-19 engrossed us in its fears, it also helped us see the world in a new lens. We realised the value of our communities. We realised the importance of life and what truly matters in it. We had to unlearn old patterns and realise that happiness lies in little things. Simple things we overlooked months ago, like a hug or calling over to our friends or family. These simple things we took for granted, and we now look forward to them every single day. This pandemic has taught us it is time we appreciate our close ones and be grateful for what we have, and reminds us that life is fragile. It's time to work together and lift each other up. These past months, we've witnessed a vast sea of kindness and compassion in our communities around the world. It's led to countless acts of selfless heroism in hospitals and care homes. Among other things, the pandemic has required us all to draw on skills and attributes such as adaptability, resilience, positivity, tenacity, and empathy. And we've been so fortunate to see our planet heal, if only temporarily, during this period of lockdown. In your graduation booklet, in this case on the front cover, just inside the front cover, you'll actually see two satellite images of Beijing before and during lockdown. The air pollution covering a substantial part of northeast China is indicated in colour. And you can see different colours marking different levels of pollution. As the sky cleared up, you'll see the second image shows an absence of colour. And that was taken during lockdown where there was no traffic on the streets in northeast China. And you can see effectively how the skies have cleared, and you can see the impact of pollution on our planet. And that's just China. Multiply that, okay, by a factor of 10 or 20, and you get an idea of the impact of pollution on the planet as a whole. Also, as we withdrew to our homes, wildlife took to our streets. Again in your graduation booklet, this time inside the back cover, you'll see an image of a fox wandering through Grafton Street. main shopping street in Dublin, for those of you, I'm sure you're well known. but you'll not see this again. I don't know where he's going. But I don't know whether those of you who know the pubs of Dublin, but it seemed to me he was heading for the Bailey. I don't think he was going for Johnny Fox's anyway. He's quite far away. But unfortunately, nobody told him the pubs were closed. The pandemic's most important lesson, I suggest, has taught us to let nature heal itself and not to take it for granted. Our planet is all we have. We cannot exploit it any more than we have already. Then in March 2020, in a very short period of time, you had to adapt to an entirely new way of learning. Gone was the ability to sit in lectures and labs with fellow students. Isolated at home, online classes required you to become more independent in your studying and assignment work. And it is a testament to your adaptability that you survived and thrived in this independent way of learning. These skills will serve you well in your respective careers. Your learning will be lifelong as you independently upskill and your field changes over the coming years, when the learning skills forced upon you by COVID will serve you well. As a COVID generation, you've largely had to acquire these valuable skills yourselves. But remember, nobody can take them from you. COVID pandemic has also affected the way we work. When COVID first hit, businesses and enterprises that could adapted to an entirely remote way of working, including innovative ways of customer service, such as five-star restaurants transformed to food trucks. Now, many of these changes are here to stay. I'm not sure about the food trucks, but certainly remote and hybrid working are here to stay. COVID has also seen rapid innovation, particularly in the medical field. With the advent of mRNA vaccinations originally developed for COVID, now being trialled for malaria and HIV vaccines currently under development. An innovative change in the field of education is the expansion of apprenticeship-type learning from traditional trades to administrative and professional work. The major challenge for us as educators, and indeed as a community, is to change people's attitudes to apprenticeships. People consider apprenticeships as only relevant to the trades, in particular the building trade. Whereas in countries like Germany, leaders of major multinationals employing thousands, in some cases hundreds of thousands of employees, okay, started life. These leaders started life as apprentices. Griffith is already an education provider for two national apprenticeships in healthcare and bar management. Allied to this are the development of micro-credential awards for individual modules of courses, allowing learners to learn at their own pace, to try courses in a different field, or enhance their skills further. Your COVID-acquired skills ideally place you to exploit micro-credentials. On the national front, Ireland is being held up globally as a shining example of determination and solidarity, how as a society we faced COVID head-on. Clear messaging emanated from government and health authorities, followed by imposition of appropriate restrictions, which were eased and reimposed in a fluid fashion as circumstances required, and we've even witnessed that this week. The common focus and lack of divisiveness was heartening and reassuring, as is today's announcement that, in fact, it is hoped that we are now, basically, the curve is now beginning to flatten and that we won't require a lockdown before Christmas. So let's continue to observe the necessary disciplines to ensure that doesn't happen. The government approach seeking buy-in, rather than being heavy-handed, elicited a very positive response and resulted in a high level of compliance with sometimes extraordinary restrictions, and that aided us to flatten the curve. It allowed for the gradual easing of restrictions, but again, I say, as the number of COVID infections increase, we have to be vigilant. We have to, they're increasing rapidly, so we have to resume our buy-in. And try as far as possible to prevent another lockdown. The various financial support schemes costing 12 billion since the start of the pandemic have demonstrated to us the value of solidarity. Your mission is to pass these lessons of solidarity, agility, resilience, tenacity, and empathy to the next generation. In this respect, this year's graduates are in good company. Griffith students have won external awards across all faculties, including in accountancy, the ACCA International Accountancy Examination, first place in the world, in strategic business reporting, scoring 94%, the highest mark worldwide out of 8,395 students. Say that again. 94%, the highest mark out of 8,395 students. A student won the Gallery of Photography Graduate Award in 2020. Another two won S Media Photographer of the Year in 2019 and in 2020. A former student, now graduate, won the Public Relations Institute of Ireland Young Communications Professional Award of 2021. And another student, in this case, won Video Journalist Award of the Year Award in S Media. Our film students won Best Film Documentary Short at the Prague International Film Festival, Best Film at the LGBTQ Toronto Film Festival 2021, Best LGBTQ Documentary at the Venice Shorts Festival in 2021. The students, film students also won official selection at the Indie Shorts Awards in Cannes and official selection of the Montreal Independent Film Festival. A design student has been shortlisted for a Future Makers Award by Design and Crafts Council of Ireland. And finally, another design student has been shortlisted for the Institute of Designers in Ireland Graduate Design Award. So these successes are not isolated. We look forward to following your career and seeing, in fact, how you will emulate the success achieved by your fellow graduates. Normally at this time, we'll give you some indication of what's the position of the economy in which many of you already have jobs, but many of you, in fact, may now be moving into the job market. You probably, in fairness, say, I don't think you could be moving at a better time. The job market is very much an employee's market right now. Growth in the Irish economy is evident from news that Ireland remains on the shortlist for billions of euros of investment by Intel, and also by the increasing number of high-tech growth companies setting up in Ireland or expanding their operations already established in Ireland, internationalizing their operations that are established here. Examples of recent new investments include TikTok and Riot Games opening a new remote broadcast and content production center in Dublin. An Irish-led Sunry raised 50 million for cloud security platforms. Announcements of new jobs in IT and pharmaceuticals sectors are regular occurrences, almost on a weekly basis. So, you know, bear in mind you're heading into a very, very vibrant and very active economy, and we wish you well. Those of you who are putting yourselves first on the job market, we wish you well. Limerick is no exception to this success. Announcements of new investments in the region are now becoming commonplace. Edwards Life Sciences is the most recent to avail of all Limerick has to offer, and it brings 250 new positions. The city has a pace and dynamism not found almost anywhere else in Ireland, I'm told, by my wife who comes from Limerick. Limerick has been named European City of Future in its population category, as well as ranking first for business friendliness and foreign direct investment strategy in its population category. It was recently included on the Atlantic Edge European Embrace. And that represents a dynamic new brand for Limerick City, which was promoted nationally and globally. As a growing destination for inward investment, tourism and education, and as a great place for people to work in. And the city, by the way, now has a student population of 21,000. As the college celebrates 15 years in the heart of Limerick City, we are happy to be part of this dynamic and to contribute to the ongoing success of the city. And now a note of caution. For those of you, and many of you in fact will have already started the transition from working online to working in the office. There's been a slight interruption recently where we've been urged to work at home, okay? But we are in the process of back to the office. And we're suggesting for you the following guidelines. For those of you who find yourself now in a company meeting, in the company meeting room, at a meeting in the company meeting room, and not online. Number one, rule number one, do not attend your dressing gown. You'll be unable to turn off the camera. Number two, Do not share with your colleague that your boss is talking rubbish. You'll be unable to go mute. Number three, do not point out when you're at a meeting with other people physically that the sound is all clear at your end. Much less something's wrong with your hearing. Do not make faces in response to ridiculous suggestions by your boss. You can't go off video. And number five, do not offer to switch on sharing. Number six, and particularly important, at an open meeting, do not offer to host the meeting, particularly if it's already been chaired by your boss. And finally, we suggest that you might, lest you be tempted, you might say, if you haven't, can't lay your hands on the document, you might say, well, unfortunately, it wasn't attached, particularly when you've been physically given that document 15 minutes earlier. So those are the rules for the new life working in the office. And effectively, it is actually a change for many of us. Many of us are used to working effectively online and got into that habit. And now, in fact, we have a completely new set of, well, not new, but we're reliving a set of work practices which we should be well familiar. And for us, we're back in campus, and I wish to extend a warm welcome to our business students graduating here today, their guests and their program directors, Judy Burke and Irish McCarthy and Richard Milan. Today, our business students will receive awards from Quality and Qualifications Ireland, Heritage Water University and the Institute of Commercial Management. Their awards range from certificate to master's degree. A number of graduates today are Chinese. I would urge any of you who expect to function successfully in the commercial world in the 21st century to visit China and indeed learn Chinese. And to our Chinese graduates both here and those watching online, may I say, Jin Jian, Woman Fichang Gao Jing, Chin Da Le, Woman Zhongguo De Shuxing De Jia Jiang He Qing Yao. Jin Jian, Wo Xiang Ni Men Du Fu Mu Shuo, Ni Men Zai Ireland Shu Qi Fichang Du Li, Yin Wei Yo Ni Men, Zhongguo De Wei Lai Er Gong Jia Mei Li. To explain, perhaps not just to our English-speaking colleagues, but maybe to our Chinese as well. I've just welcomed the Chinese families and friends and stated they should be proud of their sons and daughters' achievements. To our Indian graduates, Baharti Chatral, Ma Apka or Apke Kawalunka, Swagat Kartahun. To our Nigerian students, Ma Pipa de Naija, How far? How you day? No wahala. May I also thank our Brazilian students for their contribution to Griffith College. Obrigado por sua grande contribuição a Griffith College. To our German students, wir begrüßen alle unsere deutschen Studenten und ihre Familien, die gekommen sind und gemeinsam mit ihnen zu feiern. And to our Polish students, witamy ciebie, swojrodzi I przyjaciół. As you have had your challenges in relation to COVID and all that was needed to adapt to it, we also have our challenges in Griffith. And key to the value of your award today will be our national degrees basically becoming Griffith College degrees under delegated authority. We expect that within a short period. But there should also follow, ultimately, university status, now open to Institute of Technology through amalgamation, which, given our size, should be open to us. We, too, have to have faith. As you glimpse the world from your current mountain peak, to which I referred earlier, may I express the hope that Griffith College would have found a place in your hearts, as you have in ours. I want you to know you're always welcome on campus, socially or educationally, or just to show off the new BMW. May I conclude by congratulating you on that success and by wishing you may harness the knowledge and experience you acquired here in Griffith College to achieve what you richly deserve, a successful and fulfilling career. Thank you.
Anishpa William Falter Kur Riv Las Wera Limni Tom Ruddle Lowert Linner Kemaha. I would like to invite Deputy Mayor Tom Ruddle to address the graduates.
Thank you very much for inviting me here, and thank you, Diarmuid, for those kind comments. I appreciate that. I was a graduate from Griffith College in Dublin about 6 years ago, so I suppose going back to education is important as well. I suppose you kind of learn as you go along in life. You start off when you're young, we think we know it all, but then as you go on, you realise there's an awful lot more to learn. So I think education, to try and keep it going, just because you have got so far, you can always do better. So well done to everyone here today. I'd just like to say, President of Griffith College, Professor Diarmuid Hegarty, lecturers, graduates, parents, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your kind invitation to address you here today on your special day. Today is a day of pride. It's a day that you can all take a bow and celebrate the hard work which you have done over the past number of years. It's a day for families as they celebrate your achievements with you. Attaining education success happens to us at various times of our lives, whether you're continuing on from second level or returning to education after years away. It is all culminating in this ceremony for you to soon to be graduates of Griffith College Limerick. Students from a range of subjects, business, computing, engineering, and hospitality, they will be conferred with their certificates, diplomas, ordinary and honours undergraduate degrees and master's degrees today. It's a very special time for some to be graduates as you forge a career in a city and region that's able to provide you all the professional and personal resources that you desire and require. Today is also a special day for Griffith College. Another graduating year is yet again time to celebrate. These graduations come with the disruption of COVID-19 as a backdrop. Your teaching and learning has been hugely impacted over the past 2 years. Yes, you continue to provide the highest quality of teaching, and this has resulted in the high grades attained by your graduates. Your success in Limerick is down to hard work and commitment. Griffith has been a trailblazer in setting up City Centre campuses with his predecessors, HSI, established in 1951, the Midwest Business Institute in 1988, and then Griffith College itself came to the city in 2006. And you are continuing to innovate and add new courses. Your links with lifelong learning and your development of programs that directly relate to the requirements of business and industry in the Midwest region are important. In addition, they offer another education option for the people of Limerick City region. Congratulations to all those involved in this year's event, and Gorib Mila Mahagoyv, Agus Gonera, and Tave Liv Golair. And thank you very much, and wish you all the best in your future careers. Thank you.
Anish, but while I'm fighting to arrive, could he encourage them, okay, in a month for a colleague, the Nashunta, Augustider Nashunta, Ervic Lane and Colostra. I now welcome you to the part of our proceedings at which national and international awards will be conferred on the learners of the college, and I declare open this awards ceremony. Iramar and Tolliv Dermot Hegarty, Uchtaron Colostra Griefa, colleague, the Nashunta, Augustider Nashunta of Runa. Erna Fowlamori, Atadar Herbert, Egan Galashta. I call upon Professor Diarmuid Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to confer awards on the learners of the college presented by the college for that purpose.
Let me first explain, if I may, the significance of this point of the ceremony. this is the act of conferring. You may have noticed that, in fact, in my earlier address, I referred to you as graduands, which is the Latin gerund, those in course of graduating. The reality is that all that needed to be done to become graduates has already been done by you. The various years of study that you underwent, the assessments that you passed, effectively proving that you had attained the knowledge and experience required to receive the accolade of graduate. All of this has been done. But this moment is the formal moment of conferring upon you your awards. This is the moment when you cease to be graduands and become graduates. So I'm going to, first of all, basically state your the conferring in Irish. And for the benefit of those who don't have Irish as a mother tongue, I'm going to confer you in English. Ar cáin coláiste grífe, agus cór le dearbhú, coláiste agus coláiste éireann, bunam coláiste ar fheall amháirí an coláiste, atá í láthair agus nach bhfuil í láthair, a bhíonn caid amach í leith na coláiste, agus irim go gcuirtear na fheall amháirí féin a bhróid. On behalf of Griffith College and Quality and Qualifications Ireland, I hereby confer the awards on the learners of the college, both here and in absentia, who have achieved the standards determined for those awards, and I ask that those learners be presented to me.
Iriminish er Judy Burke, Stuarthóir Clár, Iriminish er Herbert. I call upon Judy Burke, Program Director, to present candidates in respect of the college's business programs.
To the class of 2020 and 2021, congratulations, you did it. What a journey you have had since you first walked through the doors. The excitement and fear of your first week, I'm sure it feels like a lifetime ago. There was a wonderful mixture of characters in this group, which meant there was always a shoulder to lean on or a classmate who could lift your spirits. This was a fun and a strong-willed group, but this made the learning environment exciting and admirable. There was plenty of mistakes along the way, but there was even more moments of laughter, which can all be added to the memories you have of your time in college. Many of this group also faced personal challenges, which was not made easy, being away from home, friends and family. But together with one another, you stepped up and you put your best foot forward. I applaud you today for finding the courage to persevere and rise above these challenges, and for valuing yourself and your education. At times in these past few years, you were left with no choice but to adapt to the immense changes in your lifestyle and education. It is the ability to commit to yourself, your goals and achievements that will propel you in your career and future endeavours. Knowing that you have the ability to adapt so quickly to a shift in circumstances and situations is an excellent skill to behold. Now you stand before us here today with cemented friendships and a mountain of knowledge that will excel you in your careers and for further education. It's not every day you wake up knowing that you will remember this day today. I imagine you will not remember yesterday, and I can guarantee that you won't remember tomorrow after tonight, but you will remember the day you graduated. This group were a pleasure to teach, and the business faculty, lecturers, and all your families all come together with such pride to mark a significant milestone in your lives. We recognise the commitment, ability and perseverance that got you to this day. We will all look back with fond memories on our final year together, the year that forced us to learn patience with others, lecturers, friends, family and internet service providers. So it's important that you can all celebrate this day with your family and friends who supported you and the lecturers and staff who worked with you over the last number of years. Congratulations, all of you, and I look forward to hearing of your future successes and endeavours. So, President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed their programmes and who are worthy of the QQI Award in the Higher Certificate in Business 2020 graduates, BA Bachelor of Arts in Business Studies, Diploma in International Hospitality Management, Bachelor of Arts Honours in International Hospitality Management, Bachelor of Arts Honours in Business Studies, HRM, Bachelor of Arts Honours in Business Studies, and Bachelor of Arts Honours in Accounting and Finance. So, Bachelor of Arts in Business, Jack Francis Heatherman. Diploma in International Hospitality Management, Camilla Lopez Marzetto. Bachelor of Arts Honours in International Hospitality Management, Chinsitsi Angel Chinunda. Simon Jemlik. Bachelor of Arts Honours in Business Study, HRM, David O'Sullivan. Joanne Payne. Emma Powell. Our 2020 graduates, Bachelor of Arts in Business Studies, Dara O'Connor. Katie Marie O'Dwyer. Kelly Mateus. Marie Fitzmaurice. Thank you. Bachelor of Arts Honours in Business Study, Aoife Ahern. Congratulations. Sabrina Barbosa Tatum. Congratulations. Maeve Buckley. Michelle Tellez Cristo Morero. John Fitzgerald. Congratulations. Keelan Floyd. Natalia Fuosca. Adriana Ribeiro Ribas. Orla Ryan. Bachelor of Arts in Accounting and Finance, Vanessa Cardinal. Robin Clohasey. Alan Cronin.
Irminish Eilish McCarthy, Stuarthóir Clár, Iarrachóirí a Herbert. I call upon Eilish McCarthy, Programme Director, to present candidates in respect of the college's graduate business school programmes.
Class of 2020 and 2021. I stand up here today addressing you all among your family, friends, colleagues, lecturers past and present, and I can't help but try and put myself in your position at this moment in time, wondering what inspiration any of us upon this podium can give to you today. But I have come to the conclusion that you are the inspiration to yourself. You made the decision that you wanted to better your education. You decided to attend those Monday morning 9 a.m. lectures. And it was you that decided to take those days off from your part-time work to complete your assessments and to meet the deadline set. So you see, you will carry that inspiration into your next chapter of life, whether that be your dream career that you always wanted or that you wish to continue your studies to the next level. In the end, the most important decision that you will make in your life is based on this inspiration. You are your own muse. Trust it and build on it and work on it to prove to yourself that this decision was right. I hope that your time with us at Griffith College has been memorable. We have spent a lot of time together throughout your studies, both remotely and in the classroom, especially our numerous field trips, our guest speaker experiences that I hope that you will reflect on in time as being a fond memory. COVID-19 has created many barriers for us, and remote learning didn't come without its challenges, especially when you can't hear me speak because I have my mic off. The famous terms, Eilish, you are muted, is something I'm sure that you can all relate to. But all of this aside, you did it. Against all the challenges, you have overcome them all. So graduates, I wish to congratulate you on your academic achievements today, and I hope that you are proud of what you have accomplished. As Malcolm X perfectly stated, education is a passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. Cohorgias Lekehema, congratulations, graduates. President, I now present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed programmes and who are worthy of their QQI and Harriet Watt University Awards. In Business Masters of Business Administration, Harriet Watt, Masters of Science in Procurement and Supply Chain Management, Postgraduate Diploma in International Business Management, and Masters of Science in International Business Management. Master of Business Administration, Frederick De Sousa. Congratulations. Alaji Fay. Patrick Halley. Robert Allen Shaw. Congratulations. Masters of Science in Procurement and Supply Chain Management, Bharat Babu. Congratulations. Rachel Carroll. Ebuka Martins Ichesi. Mirla Yadira Sarata Zavala. Rainey Francis. Godwin Furtado. Gadiswara Rao Gadiparti. Adayemi Badebo. Mariana Gutierrez Ruiz. Anirudh Hamsagara Shripada. Pauline Maria James. Sanish Joy. Abiola Namdi Kadiri. Roderick Boashi Konadu. Ram Bhupal Kongara. Nishant Murugula. Suresh Naluri. Rosa Narvez Rendon. Gertrude Patrick Nagy. Aifunanya Salazakwa Wanya. I did my best. Zainab Abisola Alarinde. Ejewaki Becky Unumi Barigo. Adamola Michael Osonuga. Abidemi Oyin Loye. Congratulations. Amita Pambongal Praksan. Ganesh Prasanna Kumar. Bipin Prathap Simhan. Arun Prakharan Gopi. Andrin Denny Pullicoden. Lekana Rajana. Hello. Daniel Salami. Leah Shabu. Jeremiah Shazu. Sukanika Sharma. Muhammad Sayami bin Kamal. Yaswant Udata. Parvati Vanasta. Sandra Vitai Atil. Mohamed Wakas. Masters of Science in International Business Management. Kenide Waralo Awan Ayi. Jobin Koshu Arap Aram Apil Abraham. That's a long name. Did I say it again? Sancia Stephen Mendonca. Naeem Onwuzurumba. Aman Singh Rajput. Kunal Sandhu. Nalinakash Tiwari. Tanya Miran.
Anish Irmarish or Judy Burke, Siorhor Clor, Irahori or Herbert. I call upon Judy Burke, Programme Director, to present candidates in respect of the college's Training and Education and Institute of Commercial Management Awards.
Now, President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed programmes and are worthy of their ICM awards. Diploma in Business Management, Alison Mulconry. Diploma in Human Resource Management, Martha Healy. Kira Murphy. Martin Owen Walsh. Our 2020 ICM Diploma in Business Management, Pierre Visser. ICM Diploma in Marketing Management, Aisling Condon.
As we conclude our conferring of awards on our graduates here today and for those attending online, we might just give a final round of applause to all our graduates and wish them well in the future. Tá an as an ishe gláis de dúshna vrona or shúd a dairí glóbar fiáushe wintamach na good lane. College now has the pleasure of announcing a number of prizes which are awarded to graduates who have achieved excellence in their studies, and I call upon the graduates to present again to receive their award from Professor Dermot Hegarty. The first is prizes awarded in respect of the Bachelor of Arts Honours in Business Studies. The best academic achievement on the Bachelor of Arts in Business Studies is awarded to Emma Powell. Following prize is awarded in respect of the Master of Science in Procurement and Supply Chain Management. The best academic achievement on the Master of Science in Procurement and Supply Chain Management is awarded to Rachel Carroll. Every year we make a prize in respect of the Student of the Year, and we're delighted that the Student of the Year prize will be awarded at this ceremony. It's awarded to a Master of Science in Procurement and Supply Chain Management learner. The prize of the Best Student of the Year 2021 is awarded to Abedemi Oleloyi. Ian Urica, Alas Wera, Ahuin Uishle, Kurim Clearclash and Sharmanisha, Kuntavakhtani of Runa, or Aulamorian Kloster, Berambuikas Liv Galair. Distinguished guests, Deputy Mayor, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony for the purpose of conferring awards on the graduates of the college. My best wishes and thanks to you all. While the graduates are here with us, I'd like to take this opportunity to briefly mention the Griffith College Alumni Network. With over 40,000 graduates living in Ireland, Europe, and in over 120 countries worldwide, the network is an excellent way to stay in touch with classmates, fellow graduates, and the college. The network is also proving to be a valuable resource for recent graduates who are seeking or changing employment. As the college moves towards its 50th anniversary, we're also delighted to see our graduates from earlier years using the network to recruit Griffith graduates to meet their own organization's needs. Details of the network are on griffithalumninetwork.com and on the college's website. Finally, we would like to thank all our graduates and their guests for your attendance here today and for your attendance online. For those who are attending in person today, we regret that we're not in a position on this occasion to invite everyone to stay afterwards and mingle with us indoors to celebrate over drinks and refreshments as we had planned and hoped. We recognise that health and safety must remain our first priority, and thank you for your support and compliance under these continuing particular circumstances. For now, we would like to wish all our graduates every joy and happiness in celebrating your success with your close friends today and in the days ahead. And as a token, we've small boxes of chocolates for everybody as you leave the auditorium today. In the future, and hopefully near future, we look forward to meeting you again on campus without restrictions as you continue to develop your successful careers. In the meantime, please stay safe and well. Please stand for the academic procession.